You're watching 8-Bit Days a Week, and I'm back to playing PlayStation Classic here, and it has been a few weeks already, so the modification scene is coming along nicely. I'm able to mod it now, and we're just going to see how well it looks like, sort of a performance test. And starting off with Gran Turismo 2 here. And I won't be meddling with the settings here, as we can see that part of the hack includes being able to modify a few things, such as frame skip. And it's actually, I believe it's actually better if you remove the frame skip, but just for the series of videos, I'm gonna try out games and I will just leave the show FPS on and let's see how it looks like. Actually, all right, we see there. Well, I do hope you see it on my capture. The frames per second. Let's see how it looks like. I'm just gonna use a replay here. Here's a classic. And yeah, Gran Turismo 2. One of the shocking games. I mean, why wasn't it included in the first place? And maybe they're having trouble or too lazy to do some performance tweaking on the PlayStation Classic. So I do believe this is available on the PlayStation Network. Someone tell me if it's not. I don't think it is though. Certified Classic. I did sync in. Boy, I don't know. A lot of hours in this game. Especially the endurance races where you're forced to sit and play a track straight for about 2 hours, give or take. Well, that was grueling, but I enjoyed every second of it. Of course, I was just using the, I should say, kind of broken card. What was it called? It has really big spoilers. Escudo, I think. Someone correct me if I'm wrong. It's a big red card that has really insane speed, but qualifies for most of the races anyway. Here's one of the games where you could just really appreciate the replay. Man, imagine back then. I really think that this was already very realistic. Looking at it today, though, it's a grainy mess. And regarding the performance, it looks good. We're in a solid 60 frames there. Sometimes they're at 59, but not by much. It's 59.8. So at least on a constant 60. And the game looks smooth enough, at least. Since I played this, the last Gran Turismo game I played was the one on PlayStation 2, Gran Turismo 4. And since I never had a PS3 or PS4, is looking good. Of course, this is just a simulation disk. I didn't actually load the arcade disk on the classic, even though I can. Anyway, I don't really mind what's offered in there. Maybe I could change it next time. I'll load that up instead, since this is definitely like a time sink game. You really have to spend a lot of hours. And we can see that I think the resolution changes from screen to screen depending on what we're looking at. This looks nice. Let's anyway, we're just testing it out. Let's see if I can join some races here. No, not here though. Okay. Room short. Alright, you'll have to forgive me if my performance isn't up to speed. It has been a while since I played this. Remember that we can always change the frame settings there. I just left it to auto because we're trying to find out how it runs with minimal tweaking. I basically just showed the frames per second there so you all just have a good idea. And I am running behind here. Mistake in the beginning, another mistake there. Three place. Man, feels bad to be losing to all these cars. But I think should be slower than what I'm using right now. Of course, they might have something modded. And of course, Gran Turismo, one of my favorite aspects of the game is that I think it's one of the few first. But at least the music. Since we have the CD audio quality music that the PlayStation offers before, so it definitely offers real tracks from actual artists, not covers, and not in a 8 or 16 bit kind of way, or not even a 32 bit kind of arrangement. Second here. I wonder if I can still make it. Alright, great. Too early there. Okay, so I'm just... Oh no. One mistake, and I'm last. Oh well. It's been a while. Yeah. It still plays great. I'm just the one who had the issue there, but at least there you go. Gran Turismo 2 on the PlayStation Classic. So at least you shouldn't feel bad about getting a classic, because you can modify it easily and add your own games that you probably grew up with. I'm gonna go ahead and end the video here. You catch more videos of me testing out other games for the PlayStation Classic and see how well it goes. If you're watching 8-bit days a week, please do comment, like, and subscribe.